Mention the two strategies evolved to prevent self-pollination in flowers. Now students, let us understand what are the techniques in which the flowers will avoid self-pollination and go for cross-pollination. Now what happens if self-pollination occurs continuously? Now when self-pollination occurs, now this decreases the vigor and the vitality of a particular race. Now the strength of the plant will be reduced, and since there is no variations, there would be less chances for these plants to survive, suppose if any changes occurs in the environment. And always nature selects cross-pollination over self-pollination. Now flowering plants have developed many devices to discourage self-pollination and to encourage cross-pollination, and these devices are called as outbreeding devices. Now among them, the two strategies are dichogamy and self-sterility. Now these two are the common techniques evolved by the plant so that it ensures cross-pollination will occur. Now the first one is, first we'll study about declining and then go to dichogamy and self-sterility. Now declining means unisexuality. Now some of the flowers are bisexual in nature. In bisexual flowers, both andrecium and gynecium would be present, and there would be more chances for self-pollination, and there would be some chances for cross-pollination also to occur. Now if the flower are unisexual, that means either they will be staminate flower or pistillate flower. Staminate flower will only have the andrecium and pistillate flower will have only the gynecium. Now since the flower contains either the male reproductive structure or the female reproductive structure, now such a flower is called as unisexual flower, and in such flowers there would be no chances for self-pollination to occur. So this is one outbreeding device in which the plant ensures that only cross-pollination will takes place. Now these plants can either be monoecious or dioecious. So monoecious plants are one which will have both male and the female reproductive structures would be present in the same plant, but the flowers can be unisexual. Now maize is an example for a monoecious plant, but it produces either the male flower or the female flower. And dioecious plants, it will be either having only the male flowers or only the female flowers, but not both together. So papaya is one example. Now the papaya, the plant can be a male plant or a female plant, because either they will produce staminate flowers or pistillate flower. Now dichogamy. In case of dichogamy, the maturation of anther and stigma occurs at the different time. So the flower is bisexual in nature. It has both andrecium and gynecium, but both will not mature at the same time. The anthers may mature first when compared to the stigma, or the stigma matures first when compared to the anther. So since there is a difference in the maturation period, self-pollination will not be possible in case of dichogamy. Now dichogamy can be protoandry or protogyny. So in protoandry, anthers mature earlier than the stigma of the same flower, so their pollen grains becomes available to the stigma of the older flowers. In protogyny, stigma mature earlier so that they get pollinated before the anther of the same flower develops. Now these are the two devices. The next one is self-sterility. In self-sterility, due to the presence of self-sterile genes in some flowers, pollen grains do not germinate on the stigma of the same flower. Now here the flower would be bisexual. They will have anther and the stigma, but the pollen grains of the anther of the same flower, they will not germinate because there would be a gene called sterile genes. Now when these genes are expressed, the proteins prevent the anthers which belongs to the same plant or same flower to germinate on it so that cross pollination will occur. Example is tobacco and potato. Now these are the outbreeding devices in which self pollination would be prevented and cross pollination would be ensured.